darkness before dawn. We have no quarrel with you. Please go. I will commend your soul to the gods. let us carefully appraise the situation.
Strength. I will commend your soul to the gods.
Before dawn.
Magic, come to our our aid. Before dawn.
Take this! Well, of course. Just wait for Hesaurus to start his recharging process. That's the perfect time for introductions.
Are you okay?
Well, I'll give you a few seconds. No, really, take a good look. Do you see the sweat dripping off my forehead from the pain? The wires entering sensitive parts of my body? The literal dump I'm living in? My sad, sordid excuse for a body? The sarcasm I use in a desperate attempt to hide my pain and embarrassment? I'll give you a few seconds to process all of that. Take your time.
I don't...
Now, I think you can answer your own question. Does this man look okay?
I'm sorry. We were not expecting this.
Maybe we'll step outside a moment until you're done.
Recharging? That would be advisable.
What did we just see?
I have no idea.
Whatever it was, it just redefined my idea of awkward.
The corrosion hasn't affected my hearing, you know. So, what are you here for? I imagine it's not to admire the view.
We'll be blunt. We're here because of the corrosion. Our mother's sick and we want to find a cure for her.
And everyone else, if possible.
Oh, the corrosion, huh? Sounds serious.
And we've been told that you were cured and...
That I've been... what? Cured? Ah, that's a good one.
Hey, what are you laughing about?
And you just took their word for it? Just like that? I'll be darned. One day you start wearing prosthetics, and people start spreading rumors you found a cure for the corrosion. Ah, what can I say? You pay too much attention to idle gossip.
So you're saying that despite the stigmas you're trying to hide under your prosthetics, you never actually caught the corrosion?
Oh, you spotted that, huh? Well, now that you put it that way, it depends.
Depends on what?
So, assuming I did recover from the corrosion, then you'll want to know my secret, right? And that's quite valuable information. If I tell you I didn't, you'll just leave me here to rust.
That's one way of putting it.
After all, you came all the way here from, oh, I don't know, some backwater village like Jackholm or Elon to find a cure for your beloved mother, or father, or cat, or hamster. It would be stupid of me to not take advantage of your naivete. So, I'll tell you what I want in exchange. I want a heart.
A heart? What do you mean?
Not a pulsing human heart, I admit, but a heart, nonetheless. It's a rather complicated device to be delicately inserted into my still very sensitive chest to control many of the bodily functions my own body cannot seem to.
You're not making any sense! What does it look like?
I don't know what it looks like. Do you think I would still be rotting here if I did?
You know what? I don't think you actually know anything. Even if you were a genuine survivor of the corrosion, you wouldn't actually be able to tell us how you were cured. Look at all these bottles! It's a surprise you're making any sense at all!
I need those to numb the pain.
Come on, Celine, let's go. This guy's a joke. We'll find another way.
Oh, I'm a joke, huh? Is that it? You really want to know what the heart looks like? It's a small, black monolith. It's down in the scrapyard. Get it for me, and I'll tell you everything I know. No heart, no cure, and your mother will die. And I couldn't care less if you don't believe me. I didn't ask you to come. You just barged in here. Now get out.
I will find you a heart, Sir Isoris. I promise you.
Keep your pity to yourself.
Celine, I really think...
He knows, Darian. His stigmas are real.
So that's what you were looking at while he was naked?
I don't know why he's trying to throw us off. He has the information we need, and that's worth something.
Okay. Then let's find this monolith.